Intellectual property is actually the creation of your mind. Inventors or authors, they must all be really concerned with intellectual property. India is really catching up with the international trends of dealing with intellectual property. We love working with open-minded businessmen who have a zeal for creating a greater brand.
Hello everyone. Today we have a talented young lawyer, Roshni Lachhwani, who after completing her LLM started a law firm, Intellexsys, which is specialized in dealing with intellectual property. Today she will be discussing about how important is intellectual property and what needs to be done to protect it. So let us welcome Roshni to Eureka Moment. So Roshni, thanks for coming to Eureka Moment. And before we start, we would like to know more about you. So can you just help us out with it?
Sure. So I'm a lawyer and I'm a travel, food and dance enthusiast. Now I have worked with few, legal departments in the multinational companies, few of them in India. And as well as I worked in few law firms as well earlier. However, intellectual property was a very intriguing field and I was really attracted by that. And thus Intellexsys came to being and it was primarily started to provide litigation-free legal solutions.
Oh, that's great. Okay, so to know more about you, we have divided this interview into four rounds. Starting with the first round, which is the pitch deck round. So let's start with that. Roshni, you spoke about intellectual property. So what is intellectual property basically? And can you just elaborate in a very simple manner?
Sure. So intellectual property is actually the creation of your mind. It is an intangible property. For example, brand names, music, content, and so on and so forth.
A lot of people have confusion, when you are dealing with the intellectual property. So what is the difference between a trademark, copyright, and a patent?
Okay, so trademark is something that helps you recognize the brand recall value. So for example, if I use the example of I'm loving it, so you immediately remember McDonald's. So it's something that anything that creates brand recall value. Then we come on to copyrights. Copyrights primarily protect the literary works, artistic works, dramatic works, music, sound recording, cinematographic films, and so on and so forth.
Yeah.
Protects a lot of creative works. And then we have patents, which protects products and processes.
Okay.
For example, the design and the technology used in manufacturing the Apple iPhone is protected under patents. Now the period of protection for each of these differ accordingly to the law.
So who should be concerned about intellectual property and why?
So primarily, every business who sells a product or a service, inventors or authors, they must all be really concerned with intellectual property. Primarily because intellectual property is something that helps you create strong goodwill. And eventually that's what helps you run your business in the future.
Roshni, what is your thoughts about IP seriousness taken in India versus globally?
Okay. So to be very honest, India is really catching up with international trends of dealing with intellectual property. And business persons have started, gaining more knowledge about it in the last 5 to 7 years, which I have seen, it growing. I mean, for a fact that, nowadays we don't have to really go and talk to people and pitch our business and they already know about it is a testimony to that.
Roshni, can you tell us about your initiative, Intellexsys?
So Intellexsys is primarily about providing honest opinions from a branding and a legal standpoint, which helps in creating great brands with legal protection. Now Intellexsys provides multiple services such as we help in drafting and filing of trademark applications, patent applications, copyrights. Then we also help in the field of information technology laws, media laws and franchise law. Having worked with clients across all fields such as restaurants, IT developers, brand consultants, not only in India but also globally. Now we love working with open-minded businessmen who have a zeal for creating a greater brand.
In India, do startups really benefit from intellectual property?
Intellectual property, increases the brand value for anyone who applies for an intellectual property. However, the businesses have to really take, legal action towards protecting these brands.
Yeah.
Further, the government of India has provided, you know, specific benefits for the startup. For example, by providing them a list of startup facilitators such as myself, to wherein, you know, the professional fees are not borne by the startups but rather by the government of India, so that there is a relief to the startups on a monetary end.
You spoke about legal actions to be taken, right?
Yeah.
So if some company, all right, some company copies an IP of another company,
mm-hmm.
so what needs to be done in that case?
So actually at the outset what we do is we discuss with the company the extent of the infringement and we understand exactly whether we should take this into a legal action or not, or we should
yes.
further the legal action or not. And accordingly, we decide the, you know, best dispute resolution mechanism that's available to us.
Okay. When it comes to intellectual property, how much time does it take to, you know, resolve a dispute?
So if it is settled offline, then it takes approximately say 1 to 2 years.
Okay.
And if it is, you know, taken into court or there is a legal face-off, then it might take up to 2 to 5 years and maybe even more.
We have finished our first round and we will start with our second round, which is the round of three. Un, dos, tres. Three suggestions you want to give, you know, whoever, you know, is dealing with intellectual property.
Point number one, I'd like to tell them to avoid riding over any existing brands. For example, using any designs or color combinations of competitors or existing brands. For example, they can actually like do an advanced search on Google to check whether something exists before them or not. Point number two is that, you know, to understand the fact that an idea cannot be protected, but the unique expression of it. Lastly, I'd like to say that, you know, they must always converse over email with businesses to maintain record and confidentiality, because emails also can be considered as legal evidence.
Three situations you remember, a client got into trouble for not filing or wrongly filing of intellectual property.
So one of the situations was when a client applied for a logo application and did not apply for a wordmark application, eventually losing their rights over the wordmark. That means the phonetics, how you pronounce the brand name.
Okay.
And eventually many others started using that particular brand name and they could do not much about it. And this led to dilution of the mark itself. That means that no one can claim the wordmark eventually. Now what happens in this case, we can't really help them really a lot, but only goodwill or strong usage of the mark, which eventually leads to a brand value that can save them post such errors. So another instance is that, you know, half knowledge is really dangerous as we all know, and suing on such half knowledge is even more risky. Now ideas cannot be protected. Now even if you get a registration certificate as a grant, now, enforcing it legally can be a really difficult task. Now, you know, clients fail to understand this most of the times. Now, but however, to put it simple, you know, for every Uber, there is an Ola and Mail Grab service available.
Yeah.
And intellectual property tries to strike a balance between monopoly and competition. And thus, ideas are not protected. And a third instance that I can remember is when a client had applied for a patent application for a commonly existing and a commonly used process and obviously did not get a grant for that application and eventually lost a lot of money simply because of lack of knowledge.
So Roshni, Indian government is taking a lot of initiatives, but what are the initiatives they should take to increase the number of patents in India?
So, one of the initiatives that they must do is undertake seminars, you know, for a lot of business owners, inventors and authors offline. And the other initiative that they have actually started is something called as IP Nani, where they share informative videos. And these videos, however, should have a larger audience and a, you know, much more reach so that they can reach every home.
Yeah.
And thirdly, they've already taken a very nice initiative called the Startup India scheme, under which they provide relief to startups from professional fees.
Yeah.
However, you know, I think there should be more awareness created about it, since a lot of startups are not really aware about it.
Yeah, makes sense.
Three advantages of filing a patent globally versus just in India.
So number one is the timelines are really shorter to obtain a patent.
Yeah.
Number two, they have certain benefits and privileges with respect to protections of business methods and games and such other privileges which are not provided under the Acts of India. And thirdly, you know, protection granted to them in another country for a patent can help them in licensing the patent in that particular country and gaining benefits in monetary terms.
Roshni, what are three steps a company should take if they know that their IP is being copied?
So, number one, they must approach the company, the opposite party directly, and make sure that they bring it to their notice about the original ownership. Many times the other parties are not aware of the same.
Yes.
Number two, if it does not get solved through a direct approach, then I would recommend a legal notice is definite.
Yeah.
However, if the further doesn't get solved, that is into the third step. If it further doesn't get solved, then we have multiple dispute resolution options available to choose from.
So here we come to our end of the second round, and we are moving to our most important round, which is the Eureka moment round. So let's start with it. So Roshni, can you put some Roshni on your Eureka moment?
Okay. So my Eureka moment was actually when I realized how casually intellectual property was being dealt with as an ad hoc practice. No proper consultation was being provided with respect to the branding needs, which also form a part of intellectual property.
Yeah.
However, an in-depth understanding of the practice was the need of the hour.
Yeah.
And I realized that, and I took an initiative to primarily focus on intellectual property by giving it its due importance by providing blatant opinions regarding the same. So it is important for businesses to build great brands, and we ensure that our customers, you know, really follow the legal rules, so that we can meet both their branding and the legal requirements, and we try to strike a balance between both of them.
So Roshni, thanks for the Eureka moment, and with that we will move to our last round of this interview, which is the rapid fire round. One person who keeps you motivated?
My mother.
So Roshni, one thing you will do to change the world?
I love to save the environment by planting lots of trees.
So which is your favorite section in law?
Intellectual property. I think that goes by default.
So Roshni, you are a lawyer now, but
yeah.
What was your biggest lie in your life?
I think lying to my mom for going out with my friends.
What is the latest achievement that you are proud of?
So one of the latest achievements that I have is that I was nominated for the Asian Legal Business India Law Awards under the youngest achiever under 35 category.
So your last question for today.
Yes.
Okay. And the fill in the blanks. Okay. So tarikh pe tarikh, tarikh pe tarikh, aur kya milti hai?
Fir se tarikh.
We have come to the end of this interview. We would like to thank Roshni for coming to Eureka Moment and share a knowledge about intellectual property and our initiative. And if you have loved this video, please like,
share
and subscribe.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Dr. Anirudh Malpani. I'm an IVF specialist as well as an angel investor. And I'm looking forward to featuring on Eureka Moments. So make sure you catch me there.